This virtual flight from the Chinese military positions at Bum La above Tawang illustrates the problem of the defense of Tawang. The Chinese are situated in the Tibet Plateau, 4,500 meters up at the Bum La Pass. From here, Tawang is just about 14 kilometers away as the crow flies and is over 1,500 meters down below. That means the Chinese are sitting high up and defending Indian forces are below, which is never a great situation for defenders. The Chinese have built a network of excellent motorable roads right up to the Indian border and several new villages near the border. The area around the Bum La Pass is a flat plateau for several kilometers before it starts descending towards Tawang. This area could be used for amassing troops and armor for a mechanized assault to push Indian forces off the edge, as it were, and dominate the heights. The Chinese tactical advantage is illustrated in this map that shows what the area looks like from the Chinese side. Imagine a satellite floating somewhere above Lhasa in Tibet, looking down towards India. The green line is the Chinese highway, the S202, that runs down towards the border near Tawang. On the left side, that is, towards the east, branching off from the highway, are roads that go along the Subansiri River Valley towards India. This goes past the town of Lunze, where a new Chinese airport is being built. Technically, the Chinese could mount an assault on Tawang while creating a diversionary attack from the Lunze side on the Subansiri River. However, a lot of things have changed from 1962, when the Chinese had actually reached Tawang. The Indian Army is positioned in strength around the area for the defense of Tawang. This short video clip shows multiple Indian Army positions ready to take the offensive to the other side if need be. In addition, in the last few years, there has been some massive and furious road building in the area. Note the area in the circle in this image from 2018. The same area in 2020 shows multiple roads. Note that steep mountains require zigzag roads and long straight highways are not possible. This image from 2020 shows virtually no roads in this area. But this 2021 image shows new roads and an excavator hard at work through the winter making those roads. No wonder the Chinese are getting jumpy. Aside from this, multiple military preparations have been reported in the media recently. Here we see Chinook helicopters moving heavy artillery into position. Multiple barrel rocket launchers. Anti-aircraft and anti-drone defenses. Bunkers and anti-armor defenses. Despite all this, the Chinese could mount a diversionary attack further east via the Subansiri River Valley to tie down Indian defences. The Chinese road to Tawang can also supply their forces in this area, and the new airport at Lunze can be a logistics hub. However, an attack via the Subansiri Valley is unsuitable for the use of mechanized forces that the Chinese prefer. This virtual flight along the river shows narrow valleys, a fast-flowing river, and dense forests on steep mountainsides. Nevertheless, the Chinese cannot be trusted, and Indian defenses are being shored up in this area too. Thanks for watching. Please share and subscribe.